Baltimore state health officials have suspended surgical abortion procedures at three clinics, including one in Baltimore City.
The 11 News I team has discovered all three facilities belong to one doctor who does not have a license to practice medicine in the state of Maryland. 11 News I team reporter David Collins joins us live in the 11 newsroom with the latest. David.
Donna, the action taken by state health officials comes as they enforce new rules requiring abortion clinics to be licensed and undergo inspections. But anti-abortion activists question why the state waited so long to implement them and, in their words, failed to do background checks on those applying for a license.
There are no signs to indicate that tucked in the corner of this high-rise condo on North Calvert Street is a late-term abortion clinic. State health officials suspended surgical procedures here after a patient died from a heart attack. The doctor wasn't certified in CPR. A defibrillator at the facility didn't work. State officials found a broken defibrillator at a late-term abortion facility on Landover Road in Prince George's County, too. The clinical nurse said she had not been trained to use it anyway. The state also suspended surgery at a late-term abortion facility in Silver Spring. They found a patient who was left alone as she began to awaken from surgery. They believe she was at risk of falling or otherwise hurting herself. Public records indicate that all these clinics belong to Dr. Stephen Brigham. He owns four. He doesn't have a license to practice medicine in Maryland, and he doesn't need one to operate this type of business. The state action is triggered by new regulations that took 2 years to implement. These facilities had not faced as much scrutiny in the past because they were viewed as doctor's offices. Planned Parenthood applauds the new regulations.
Maryland has good common sense regulations in place that are appropriately safety-minded with their focus on patient safety. So in our view, the regs appear to be working.
The new regs were pushed by the Maryland Catholic Conference. In the past 3 years, there have been deaths and serious injuries at abortion clinics, facilities that were allowed to stay open until investigations were completed.
One of the reasons that we wanted these clinics licensed is because when there is a death or a serious injury at a clinic, in the past we had to rely on the Maryland Board of Physicians. And we have documentation of this takes 4, 5, 6 years.
A public record search indicates the state of Pennsylvania revoked Dr. Brigham's privilege to operate two abortion facilities. The state of New Jersey suspended his medical license back in October 2010. Anti-abortion advocates question why the state provided Dr. Brigham licenses in the first place.
One of the parts of the new regulation specifically says the secretary may deny a license to a corporate applicant if the corporate entity has an owner, director, or officer whose conduct caused the revocation of a prior license.
Court records indicate Dr. Brigham served time for tax evasion and had been charged with Medicaid fraud. Two other doctors who work with him are on probation. Dr. Murdad Alay is on probation after one of his patients suffered serious injury during a late-term abortion. Dr. James Hooper is on probation for prescribing drugs for illegitimate medical purposes.
The Office of Healthcare Quality issued 4 licenses without investigating any of this. I quite frankly find appalling.
Under the new rules, the infraction cited at the three facilities does not warrant shutting them down. The inspection of all 16 abortion facilities in the state is expected to be completed by the middle of April. Reporting live from the newsroom, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.